Similar trial with another molecule, evolocumab, 4,400 patients of OSLER 1 and 2 studies were included. Mean age was 58. Again, these patients were also had high cardiovascular risk. And these patients were also taking some kind of statin or ezetimibe in 23% of patients. So this molecule, evolocumab, was given subcutaneously 2 weekly, either 140 mg twice a week or 420 mg once a month. Follow-up was for almost 1 year, and mean LDL at the entry was around 120. Primary endpoint was same change in calculated LDL cholesterol level from baseline and incidence of side effects and cardiovascular events. As expected, significant reduction in LDL was there with evolocumab, and cumulative incidence of cardiovascular event was significantly less with this molecule. Death, MI, unstable angina requiring hospitalization, coronary revascularization, stroke, TI, and heart failure hospitalization was significantly less with evolocumab. And if you see, LDL had reached to even less than 25 mg per deciliter. And if you see side effect profile, there was no increase in side effect, any kind of side effect, whether muscle side effect, enzyme rise, or neurological events. There was not increase even when LDL had gone to less than 25. So message from this trial was that evolocumab plus standard therapy as compared to standard therapy alone significantly reduced LDL level, and that reduces incidence of cardiovascular events in a pre-specified but exploratory analysis.